So this picture I'm showing you is in Occoquan, Virginia. This city was planted in, it's not a city, it's a township of 934 people now, but it was planted in 1765. And so business has been done in the picture of the building I showed you for generations. It goes on and on and on and on. I was thinking about the generational blessings of families, and we're talking about encouraging communities, especially families. And you have responsibility for your family. I want to read a scripture, and this scripture I think frightens a lot of Christians because we really know ourselves and we know our flaws and our weaknesses. So we tend, if you're like me, like most Christians, to think of ourselves more negative than positive, and unless you really declare over your life who you are in Christ. So Exodus 25 through 7 says, "You shall not bow down to them or worship them," that's false gods, "for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sin of their parents to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me, but showing love to 1,000 generations of those who love me and keep my commandments." So what you want to do in building community in your family is really love God. So let's look at this passing down of curses to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me. Do you hate God? If you hate God, you're probably just tuning out of everything I'm saying. You're not interested in the scripture. You're not interested in generational blessing. You're not even interested in your family. So by the virtue of the fact that you're interested in passing blessing on to your family, that you want your family to prosper, that you want your family to be blessed, third, fourth, fifth, 20,000 generations, lets me know that you have an understanding of keeping the commandments of God, but you're not perfect, nor am I. And so when we think of, okay, God's going to punish my children, he's going to punish my grandchildren, great-grandchildren, because I've been stupid in life. Haven't we all? Haven't we all done silly things, stupid things? Haven't we all sinned? But we love God. I love God, and you love God. That's the difference here. When you hate God, you don't even care what you're doing. You don't care that sin is sin. You just do what you want to do without regard. To the fact that you've thought about the things I've done are going to affect my family, the things I've done may go down to my children, my grandchildren, great-grandchildren, God help me. God bless them. You're loving God. And the scripture promises showing love to 1,000 generations of those who love me and keep my commandments. Are you keeping his commandments now? Maybe you messed up in the past like I did, made some fatal flaws you think that may have got you off course, but God's love and mercy pulls you right back and gets you to the place that you truly love him and you keep his commands. And when you do that, you are passing on generational blessing. You are building community of families, healthy families. So keep it up. Let God guide your life. Let God guide your family. Keep loving him. Keep obeying him. The blessings will flow.